uit geruil word. Die meerderheid van die wetgewing is volgens die DA woordvoerder oor omgevingsake, Gareth Morgan, heeltemal aanvaarbaar, maar hy sê die deel van die voorgestelde wetsontwerp is drakonies van aard. Indien die wijziging goedgekeur word, sal mense nie hulle vriende teen uitermatige weerstandspande mag waarsku nie.
For example, a person sees a tornado heading towards a particular town or village, they would have to get permission from the weather service to warn people of it. The weather service indeed has a lot of monitoring stations around the country, but they cannot possibly know what's happening everywhere, and for that we rely on the informal network of civic-minded people.
Volgens Morgan kan mens aangekla word van 'n misdrijf as jy 'n vriend waarsku oor swak weerstandspande iewers in die land.
I doubt the weather service would seek to enforce all of these instances, but that makes bad law. Law is expected by South Africans, and it needs to be applicable. South Africans will laugh at this law if it comes into force. People tweet and blog about the weather all the time, and they should be allowed to do so this week. The greatest risk is to the informal network of people around South Africa who make a living out of interpreting the weather through their own weather station, but not only the weather service that has weather stations around the country. And in fact, this is what I think the underlying intention of the weather service is. To create a monopoly around the interpretation and dissemination of weather-related information. We should not be closing down the good people, farmers, and other people who use weather data for productive purposes or for safety reasons.
Morgan said the SAB must eerder op weerstandsmodelle en voorspellingstegnieke focus.
The weather service is paranoid. They're not doing well enough. Their commercial side of their business is struggling.